Hello, so in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a page slash post using the classic editor. Now I say page slash post because making a page and a post are pretty much the same when using the classic editor, and I'll be showing that to you now. So to get to a page, to a new page, you can either go to the top here, go to new and go to page, or you can go over here to pages here over here on the navigation menu and go to add new. And you see it leads to a new page where you can start editing your page. Or let me go ahead and show you the post real quick. If you go up here to post, go to add new post. As you can see, it's pretty much virtually the same. You still have enter your title here, and you still have this area here where you'll be putting your content. So the first thing that you're going to want to do when you're creating a new page is give it a title. And we're gonna give this one, we're gonna call this one testing 1, 2, 3. And then down here is where you can start putting your content. So you can just start writing. So let's just put testing 1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2, 3. And right here, you can see it right now, it is set on paragraph. And what you can do is you can highlight this, click on this down arrow on paragraph, and it'll make a drop down menu to where you can change the type of text that it is. So we can make it into a heading, bam. Make it nice and large, or you can choose a different heading. Let's make it heading 4, or just to change it back into a normal paragraph, just click paragraph and it's right back to normal. So I went ahead and made the testing 1, 2, 3 into a heading, and I added a couple of sentences. So next to this drop down menu here, you can see you have yourself a little toolbar, and this toolbar allows you to edit your text in different ways, like you can in Microsoft Word. For example, if I wanted to bold this text, I would highlight it, click bold, now it's bolded. Or if I wanted to have it italicized, italics, now it's italicized. Or let's say, let me go ahead and get rid of that, the bold and the italics. And I wanted to make this into, have bullets by them. So I hit the add, make it into a bulleted list, bam, and now it's a bulleted list. Or if I wanted to make it into a numbered list, now it's a numbered list. Or if I wanted to quote, make something into a quote, highlight it, bam, now it's a quote. But let's go ahead and turn it back to normal. And now you can also see that you can align your text in different ways. Like if I want it centered, make it go over here, click on it, now it's all centered. Or if I want it aligned all to the right, it's aligned all to the right, but I want it all the way back to the list. Let's get rid of that number list. Let's change this back into a heading. And this icon right here allows you to change your text into a link. So let's say if I wanted this word next, I wanted to make that into a link, I would highlight it, click this icon here, and put in the URL that you want this link to lead to. And one more thing up here is the insert read more tag. And bam, it just inserts that there, but I really don't want it there, so let's get rid of it for now. So at the very end of your toolbar, you see this icon. If you were to click on it, it expands your toolbar to give you more things you can do with your text. For example, if I highlight my text and I was to click this icon, it puts a straight line through it. I'm not really sure what the point is of that, honestly, so let's get rid of that. You can add a line here for, you can, something that you may be interested in is changing the color of your text. So let's go ahead and highlight it all. Right now, as you can see, it's kind of a gray-ish color, but we want to change it to black. And now it's black. This icon right here is special characters that you can add into your text. These two icons right here change your indent. So if you want to indent it, or if you want to decrease the indent, that's what those do. And something that is very important that you will probably use a whole lot is this undo button. If you click on it, it undoes the last thing that you did, and you continually click on it, it just undoes whatever last thing that you did. Now that we've gone over the different things you can do with your text down here, especially using the toolbar, let's go over how you can add different media like pictures and videos. To do so, all you need to do is come up here to this add media button. As you can see, it leads to my media library where I have one video and two pictures. Or if I wanted to add some more pictures to this media library or upload, what you need to do is click on upload files, click on select files. It will pull up a bunch of different documents and files on my computer that I can then upload to my media library here. But for now, we're just going to go with what's already in my media library. So let's say I want to add a picture. So let's click on this sky picture right here. Once you do that, come down here and click on the Insert into Page button. And now, that image is now on the page. Once you feel like you're done editing your page and you want to get a preview of what it will look like on your website, what you're going to want to do is click on the Preview button up here. So once you click on it, it will take you to a page that is previewing what your page will look like on your website. And as you can see here, I have testing 123 in two places, and I don't like that. So we're going to go back to our editing page here. We're going to get rid of testing 123 down here. I'm going to replace it with the words 123. Now I'm going to come back over here, hit preview, go back to that preview page. And as you can see, now it says 123. So once you feel like you're done editing your page and you really feel like you've finalized everything, what you're going to want to do is hit the publish button. So come on over here, click the publish button, and now your page will be published. So this brings an end to the video on how to create a page/post using the classic editor.